What's up, everybody? It's your boy Shazzy, and welcome back to another video. If you're new to this channel and you're clicking on me for the very first time, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and also turn that post notification button so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. Now, with that being said, let's get straight into today's content. Let's go, everybody. So today's going to be a very simple video. It's a cooking video. If you don't like these kind of videos, I apologize. I just thought to share with you guys today because my sister right here, Hansi Fuba video last, which is big. So I was like, okay, they're gonna film my uncle. Because Pana and Obas, when the fungus is not good, Pana should not go to the only thing that I can do is just go to America, the cheat seeds, and then don't talk. I do nothing. But guys, even I know some things. And this today, Pana should go to the doctor and see. Anyway, I'm just joking. So I'm making homemade fried chicken today. I've been given the task of making the chicken. As you can see, I just took it out the freezer. So this is a broiler, which is regular chicken. I just dipped it in some cold water and I'm just gonna let it defrost for the rest of the day. Again, so later on this late afternoon slash early evening, I'll start cooking the chicken. So I think basically what I'll do is I need to cut it into pieces and I'll put out the ingredients to dip it, all that, and then we'll get it popping. So I'm thinking, Kuti, do I want to do this fried or oven baked? We'll see, we'll see. Because in the I like experiments. So we'll see Kuti that says, some that say, but stay tuned. And sorry that I look a mess, I just woke up, so please forgive me. Okay guys, update. So in any I could have cut the chicken myself, but I was too scared. So now sister has cut some of the pieces, aren't they? And yeah, so at the those shoulders, yeah, I don't know. Oh, my wings, yeah. My wings. This is the other half of the body. It's gonna do the same thing. But after these chicken pieces are cut, I'm going to boil them to make sure that they cook through. But yeah. Thank you, Tenai. So I told her to do it when I have to check it. Alright guys, so the chicken has been cut. Maybe if that no go can drive. I'll just give this to the dogs. But yeah, thanks again Chennai, and then I will update you guys once we got to the next stage. Chennai would this say anyway. Okay guys, so now it's several hours later. And well, not since last time I talked to you guys, it's been an hour since then. And now I'm going to boil the chicken pieces. So here are the chicken pieces. I'm going to place them into this pot. Don't worry, my hands are clean. I'm gonna place all of them in here. And for those wondering why I'm placing all these chicken pieces in the pot, it's because I don't want to just go straight ahead and coat the chicken and just fry it straight away, because I'm afraid that if I just fry it straight away, it might not fully cook through. There might be pink in there, raw meat. So I'll now make sure that I boil it to guarantee that it's fully cooked when I fry it, because if I boil it, then it'll now be ready to be consumed and all I have to do is fry. Dixon, let's do it like a cooking video. That's the big. Okay, so now it's time to pour the water inside. Ooh. I'm so clumsy, you guys. You can already tell that this is not something that I do. Hold on, let me do my thing. And if you're wondering why it's like so dark already, it's because it's winter and it's only past 4, but it gets dark real quick in winter. Okay, so the water has been poured into the pot. And so I'm just gonna wait for this to boil. You can see the fire is going. This is just some basmati rice that was already made. So in the meantime, I'm gonna go take a bath, but when I come back, we'll get into the rest of this. But you don't wanna put too much water in there, because I was gonna put a whole lot of water. Even this is arguably a bit too much water, because the chicken pieces already have some water in them because they've been soaked in water all day. So yeah, but I'm just gonna leave the pot on, the lid off, and just set the boil like that. Hey guys, good evening. I just want to put a disclaimer. It does not take this long to cook fried chicken. Literally everything that I've done today can take you an hour or less, honestly. The only reason why I've been taking so much time to do this is because this was actually for dinner, not for lunch or anything. So now it's like, I think around 6, 7 p.m., 7 something. And yeah, so let me show you an update about what happened. So as you know, last time I told you that I basically boiled the chicken. I didn't put salt in it. I should have, but it's okay. We live and we learn. My mom ended up salting it for me, but she said that you still can't really taste much of the salt because it didn't boil with the chicken. So advice beforehand is make sure you salt the chicken when you boil with it. Don't put too much. Let's put, you know, enough. So now here I have three plates. One is with mashed eggs, breadcrumbs. These are local breadcrumbs, and I've got some flour. And what I'm gonna do, yes, and also I'll be seasoning the breadcrumbs, probably put some aromat in there and whatever spices are available in there, because the breadcrumbs is what you taste first, and that's where most of the flavor is going to be coming from. So it's important that they're seasoned well. So these are local breadcrumbs with colorant, but I'm gonna put a little more spices and things in there. Got your flour. So basically, I will show you guys when you do it, but the first thing when you take the chicken is you dip it into the flour first, and then you dip it into the egg mix, because the egg mix is gonna act as the glue, and then you dip it into your breadcrumbs. That's the last part, and then we're gonna fry it. So up to you guys when we get to that part. No, don't throw that video. Because don't throw that video. Anyway, okay guys, so here's the chicken. As I showed you guys before, the breadcrumbs going first, the eggs, then the flour. I'm just gonna place them on that plate. Up ahead here, we have the oil, which is heating up. So let me just give you a quick tutorial on how to do it. So here are the leg. Flour. Okay. that's how life goes. Make mistakes. Anyway, so it's flour. Right? So flour, eggs, and then breadcrumbs. Make sure it's nicely coated. I haven't done this in a while, so yeah. And you can always go back in the steps to make sure if you feel like it's not coated enough and all that. I'm just gonna put it there. So I'm gonna do one more on camera. Here we got sort of a sternum wing part near the shoulder. Start with our flour. And then breadcrumbs. So you can already see how messy this is going to be, but for good reason, hence why I'm wearing the gloves. I'm sure to put that. Because here's the thing, if I were to do this step without the flour or the eggs, the breadcrumbs would just immediately fall off. Put it like that. So I'm going to continue doing this for all of them, and then eventually I'm going to put all of that into the pot with the oil. Okay guys, I'm basically done cutting all the chicken. Took a bit of time, but I'm done. As you can see, the oil is hot. You can see some vapor from there, but probably can't see it from the camera. But anyway, let's get into it. So I'm going to place this piece of place this piece of chicken, put it in very gently. And because the chicken was already cooked through, I'm only gonna need to place them in there for maybe 8 to 10 minutes. So, all right, I will show you guys after I finish the finished product. Okay guys, it's done. This is the finished product. As you can see, the pieces on the bottom look burnt. They look darker. Those are the first ones we did. So we realized that because the oil was on while I was doing the whole coating process, it was really hot. So the breadcrumbs fried really quickly. So it would have actually burned. But it smelled really good though. You can smell the breadcrumbs, the spices and everything. It smells really good. I think it's gonna be good. I'm not worried at all because I know that the chicken at least was already fully cooked prior to being fried. So I recommend that. It's an important step to boil the chicken, because had I not boiled the chicken and we did this, it means that we're eating chicken that is fried, like on the surface looks done, but it's actually not. So but I'm happy with the final product. It looks good. Let me try to taste a little piece before I end off this video. Okay, you got a nice little piece right here. It's kinda hot. Okay, let me taste it, you know, and I'll be honest, I'm not gonna like beef myself up. If it I like it. It's really good. Yeah. That's really good. I'll give that a solid 9.5 out of 10. But it was really good. Yeah. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, stay tuned for the very next video. And also share this video as well if you want to. Thank you guys so much. Love you guys. Road to 200 subscribers. Let's go. Thank you, 140 subscribers. Love you guys. Bye.